Good morning, everyone. So today in Indian Constitution subject, we are going to discuss about Unit 5, Subunit 2. The title of subunit is National Human Rights Commission. Okay, in short form, we can abbreviate it as NHRC, National Human Rights Commission. So if you see the introduction part of National Human Rights Commission, the National Human Rights Commission, NHRC of India, is a statutory public body. Okay, we all know what is the meaning of statutory body. Statutory body is nothing but a non-constitutional body set up by the parliament. Okay, it is a non-constitutional body set up by the parliament. And statutory bodies are authorized to pass the law and take decisions behalf of the country. Okay, they have the authority to pass the law and take decisions behalf of the country. So this NHRC is a statutory body, public body, constituted on 12th October 1993. So it was formed or constituted on 12th October 1993 under the protection of Human Rights Ordinance of 28th September 1993. So under the Act, Human Rights Ordinance of 28th September 1993, it was formed. So the NHRC is responsible for the protection and promotion of human rights. So the main aim of this NHRC, National Human Rights Commission, is to, the function of establishing of this NHRC is protection and promotion of human rights. We all know human rights, okay, these are for the welfare of the human beings, for living or leading a proper life in the society. We acquired these human rights from our constitution and parliament. So these rights are protected and promoted by this National Human Rights Commission, defined by the Act as rights relating to life. Okay, the human rights such as rights relating to life, liberty, equality and dignity of the individual guaranteed by the Constitution are embodied in the international covenants and enforceable by courts in India. So these rights are relating to life, liberty, equality and dignity, okay, of individual guaranteed by the Constitution. Okay, these are given guaranteed by the Constitution and international covenant. What is the meaning of covenant? Covenant is an agreement, okay, that we will give these rights to the individual, that agreement they have made. So that is international covenant and enforceable by courts. Even courts also forcefully they are implementing these human rights in India. Next, if you see the functions of National Human Rights Commission, the protection of National Human Rights Commission Act mandates the NHRC to perform the following functions. See, the first one is proactively or retroactively. What is the meaning of proactively or retroactively? Proactively means like before the action take place, they have to control the thing. That is proactively. Retroactively means retroactively nothing but with effect from the date in the past is called as retroactively. So proactively or retroactively, inquire into violation of human rights by government of India. Okay, so either before or after, they will inquire in the violations. Violations means if anybody is getting violated or deprived from their rights, okay, human rights, so that will be inquired by government of India. Or negligence of such violation by a public servant, even if any public servant also showing negligence towards the human right, so that will be inquired by this NHRC. That is the first function. Then the protection of human rights and recommend measures for their effective implementation. Okay, so they protect the human rights as well as recommend measures, means precautions, okay, and necessary actions how to protect these human rights, that also suggested by this NHRC. Next, review the factors including acts of terrorism and inhibit the enjoyment of human rights and recommend appropriate remedial measures. They review the factors which disturb or which are stopping the human rights to enjoy their rights, okay, such as terrorism, that inhibit the enjoyment of human rights, and recommend appropriate remedial measures. Okay, so they suggest the appropriate precautions and alternative ways and methods to how to protect these human rights. Next, to study treaties and other international instrument. Okay, treaties. What is the meaning of treaties? Are agreement between states is called as treaties. To study treaties and other international instruments on human rights and make recommendations for their effective implementation. So they will study that what are the agreements, recommendations has given by the state government, national government and international governments also. Okay, and they make recommendations for their effective implementation. See, they see all the laws, policies and principles that the government has given these many facilities for the protection of the human rights. So they should be available to the human beings, okay, effectively. So for that they will fight. Next, undertake and promote research in the field of human rights. Okay, they undertake the research means how effectively we can protect and safeguard, and if we can add some more rights. Okay, like that they will do research in the human rights. Okay, and they will find some suggestions. I mean, they will add some more things, some points into the human rights domain. To visit jails and study the conditions of inmates. Okay, they visit the jails because the people, those who are living in the jails, though they are prisoners, though they are the victims, then also they are the human beings. Okay, they also have the right to protect and safeguard their human rights. So they visit these human rights, National Human Rights Commission people visit the jails that whether their human rights are safeguarding or not. Okay, here what is the meaning of inmates? Inmates is nothing but a person confined to an institution. See, the prisoners, they are confined to jails only, means they stay there only, okay, for certain period of time. So they are confined to the institution. So in that institution, in that prison, jail, even if the person hospital also, like for example, if you take mental hospital, okay, or any psychologically disorder person, those who are staying in the hospital because of their disability, okay, so they will confine for that particular place only. So in that place, are they receiving their human rights properly or not? For that purpose also they visit and they will check those people's condition. Next, engage in human rights education among various sections of society. Okay, so human rights education, each and every, see, this is very important. Each and every individual have the knowledge of human rights, okay, so that he can avail those things, and so that he cannot cause any harm to other individuals also if he know the human rights. So engage in human rights education among various sections of the society and promote awareness of the safeguards available for the protection of these rights through publications, the media, seminars and other available means. Okay, so like, see, in our education, see, you have one topic as Human Rights Commission. So like that you will get awareness about this Human Rights Commission. So like that only they are spreading awareness about this Human Rights Education, Human Rights Commission, through education, seminars, media, publications. They are publishing books, articles in the newspapers, journals and periodicals, so that they can give awareness to the individuals and the society members in order to protect and safeguard these human rights. Next, encourage the efforts of NGOs. What are NGOs? Non-governmental organization. They are not from the government department. Okay, they are the voluntary organizations. Okay, because they want to serve to the society. Okay, they want to bring change in the society. For that reason, they establish and they also working and contributing towards this Human Rights Commission. So, encourage the efforts of NGOs and institutions. Congress to working in the field of human rights. Okay, Congress means what? Those who are assembling or gathering for its formal discussion, that is called as a Congress. Okay, Congress is a formal meeting for discussion between delegates, especially from a political party, also called as Congress. So where the people are meeting together for a formal discussion, so here they are gathering together for the discussion about the Human Rights Commission, like NGOs and other people also. So for their work also and for their effort also, this Human Rights Commission appreciates. Then it considers the necessity for the protection of human rights. It considers the necessity for the protection. See, it is very important. See, otherwise what happened? Human rights, human if any individual or the society members are not availing their human rights, what happen? Their life become miserable. Okay, they cannot lead a good and satisfied life if they are not availing their rights. So it is a very necessary aspect of our life that we should get, and we should avail the human rights. And requesting any public record or copy thereof from any court or office. Okay, so this human rights, National Human Rights Commission also request any public record or copy from any court of office. Okay, so from any court of office they will request any file. Okay, if they want to review of any human rights violation or anything, so they can request the public record or copy from any court, so that they can see the how human rights are implemented, how they are violated, if in any case such case has occurred or happen. Okay, so that is also one of the function of NHRC. Next, composition of NHRC means how it is constituted, its members and all. So the NHRC consists of a chairperson who has been a Chief Justice of India or a judge of the Supreme Court. Okay, NHRC consists of a chairperson who has been a Chief Justice of India or a judge of the Supreme Court. Okay, then one member who is or has been a judge of the Supreme Court of India. Okay, then one member who is or has been the Chief Justice of a High Court. Next, three members out of which at least one shall be a woman to be appointed from amongst persons having knowledge of or practical experience in matters relating to human rights. Okay, so these three members, one person should be woman, because there are rights regarding to women also. Okay, so for that purpose also she if the member is from a woman, okay, she can look after in such aspects very carefully. Okay, matter relating to human rights. Then in addition, the chairpersons of national commissions like National Commission for SC and ST, Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe, okay, women, minorities, backward classes, protection of child rights, and the chief commissioner for persons with disabilities serve as ex officio members. See, in addition, the chairpersons of national commissions, National Commission for SCST, see, the persons belonging to these commissions also, they form in this National Human Rights Commission as ex officio members, because see, scheduled caste and scheduled tribes, also marginalized classes, they are also not availing their rights because they are the suppressed and marginalized classes since before the independence. Okay, and women also, they are not treating well in the society. Minorities also not treated properly. Backward classes, SC, ST, BC also not treated properly. So whether they are getting their human rights or whether they are availing their human rights properly or not, for checking or supervising and investigating those things, so commissioners from these departments also form as a ex officio members for this National Human Rights Commission. Okay, and protection of child rights, even children also have their own rights. Okay, right to life, right to name, right to identity. Okay, these all things, right to citizenship also comes under the child rights. Okay, so these all things they will look after as ex officio member. And chief commissioner for persons with disability, PWD, persons with disability means the disabled members like hard of hearing, okay, physically handicapped, mentally retarded people. Okay, so such kind of people also having their own human rights. Okay, they also have the right to avail their rights. So for them also, whether they are receiving or availing those rights or not, for checking that, from these all commissions, one ex officio member will be appointed in the NHRC. Next, the sitting judge of the Supreme Court or sitting chief justice of any high court can be appointed only after the consultation with the chief justice of Supreme Court. So they will be appointed after the consultation of chief justice of Supreme Court. Then coming to the State Human Rights Commission, SHRC. Okay, this is, so the name itself indicates, State Human Rights Commission means it is in the state. NHRC is the national wide, this is state level. So a state government may constitute a body known as the Human Rights Commission, okay, of that state to exercise the powers conferred upon and to perform the functions assigned to a state commission. Okay, so a state commission, see, it is very difficult to look after the all states human rights commissions in national level. So in each and every state there will be a state human rights commission. It is easy to look after the functions, okay, and activities in the state level. Then to all the states they will recommend and they will submit their activities to the national wide. So it will be established under the state's human rights commission, okay, exercise the powers conferred upon and to perform the functions assigned to, okay, whatever functions the nation assigned to them, they will perform them. And a state commission in accordance to the amendment brought in TPHRA. What is this TPHRA? TPHRA is nothing but the Protection of Human Rights Act. Okay, so under this, these are established. Then in 1993, point number 10 of State Human Rights Commissions formed to perform the functions of the commission. So in the under the 1993, point number 10, they have mentioned the state human rights to formation and perform their functions. The commission as stated under chapter 5 of the Protection of Human Rights Commission 1993 with Amendment Act 2006. So at present 24 states have constituted SHRC, States Human Rights Commission. Appointment. Section 2, 3 and 4 of the Protection of Human Rights Act lay down the rules for appointment to the NHRC, National Human Rights Commission. The chairperson and members of the NHRC are appointed by the President of India. Okay, the chairperson and the members of the NHRC are appointed by the President of India. See, we have discussed in the functions of President, okay, that all the high officials and authority, all the commissions chairpersons are appointed by President. So like that only here also this Human Rights Commission chairperson also appointed by the President of India on the recommendations of a committee consisting of, in that committee, see, the Prime Minister as a chairperson, the Home Minister, the leader of the opposition in the Lok Sabha, the leader of the opposition in the Rajya Sabha. They are from the opposition party, not from the ruling party, and the Speaker of the Lok Sabha and the Deputy Chairman of the Rajya Sabha. So these are all members form the commission. Okay, so this is about the National Human Rights Commission and State Human Rights Commission. These main function of these commissions are to safeguard, protect and promote the human rights, okay, throughout the India. Okay, thank you.